Today I'm going to tell you about the four best energy boosting medications. These medications can help you get rid of asthenia or severe weakness caused by various diseases, including coronavirus infection. Fatigue, malaise, anxiety, brain fog, depression, and many other symptoms of long COVID-19 are described in part 1, COVID-19 recovery. Unfortunately, these symptoms are often seen in patients who have had a coronavirus infection. So today we will discuss medications that can give you more energy and restore your productivity. Let's go! What is citrulline malate and how will it help us with post-coronavirus asthenia? Citrulline is an amino acid essential for the elimination of metabolic products. Citrulline molecules are basic in the structure of the nerve sheath, hair, and nails. The term citrulline comes from the Latin name for watermelon, citrullus, as this substance was first isolated from its rind. Malate is an organic salt molecule of malic acid. The addition of malate to citrulline improves bioavailability, shortens absorption time, and also influences which effects of citrulline will be more pronounced. Citrulline is an amino acid that participates in the cycle of neutralization of ammonia in the liver, which is formed as a result of the breaking down of nitrogen-containing compounds. In other words, citrulline malate helps to detoxify the liver, as it's involved in the elimination of metabolic products such as ammonium and lactate. Citrulline contributes to the normalization of metabolism and also activates non-specific protective factors of the body. Citrulline malate supplements are used by athletes as they relieve muscle fatigue, increase stamina, training intensity, and accelerates recovery from intense physical activity. Citrulline malate is a general tonic used for asthenic syndrome, overwork, increased fatigue in the recovery period after illnesses, including after coronavirus infection. Keep in mind that citrulline malate is a potent precursor to arginine, which is, according to one theory, highly undesirable during the acute phase of COVID-19. According to this theory, arginine appears to be a key metabolite important for successful viral replication. Arginine depletion has long been investigated in vitro as a potential antiviral strategy, with the most studies performed on the families herpes viridae and adenoviridae. Furthermore, arginine is also a key substrate in the host inflammatory response, and reduction of serum plasma arginine levels could plausibly attenuate the severe inflammatory response in SARS-CoV-2 infection. In the video "Don't Drink Coffee During COVID-19", I discussed in detail why it's undesirable to consume arginine-containing foods during the acute phase of COVID-19. Links to the previous four parts on COVID-19 recovery are in the description box. However, while studying this issue, I came across a different theory. There is some evidence that women do better than men with COVID-19, and one of the reasons is that women have a lot more estrogen, and estrogen results in increased nitric oxide. NO. Laboratory research showed that NO not only inhibits the ability of coronavirus to attach to cells by decreasing the adherence capability of its S spike proteins to the ACE2 receptors, but also inhibits viral replication. The natural precursor of NO is arginine. Citrulline is the precursor of arginine, but arginine is quickly metabolized. Research demonstrates that supplementation with citrulline is more effective at increasing plasma arginine and NO levels compared to supplementing with arginine. Low levels of citrulline are associated with acute respiratory distress syndrome, which worsens the health of patients with COVID-19. I'm afraid I've completely confused you. So how can we answer the question, is arginine its precursor citrulline and arginine-containing products such as coffee, tea, cola, etc., useful or harmful to the health of patients with COVID-19? At the moment, I would answer this question like this. Given the currently available conflicting scientific evidence, it may be necessary to limit arginine, citrulline, coffee and caffeine-containing products during the acute phase of coronavirus infection. However, after recovering from coronavirus infection in the presence of asthenia, weakness, fatigue, during the rehabilitation period, taking L-arginine and citrulline malate can improve your health. Maybe you have another opinion. Please share in the comment section your thoughts and your experience on this topic. In October 2020, scientists from France published an article, "Patients with COVID-19 present with low plasma citrulline concentrations that associated with systemic inflammation and gastrointestinal symptoms." The study showed that the majority of patients with moderate to severe COVID-19 had decreased levels of plasma citrulline, which correlated with digestive symptoms and systemic inflammation. Low citrulline is likely involved in SARS-CoV-2-associated diarrhea by causing alteration of intestinal permeability and enterocyte malabsorption. It could also participate in the significant weight loss that is observed in patients with COVID-19. The recommended dose of citrulline for adults is 1 gram per day in 3 divided doses with meals. The course of treatment is from 10 to 30 days. Citrulline is contraindicated in people with rheumatoid arthritis, children under 6 years old, people with stomach and duodenal ulcers, during lactation, in the first and second trimesters of pregnancy. In late pregnancy, citrulline may be prescribed to improve cord blood flow. Pregnant women are strictly prohibited from drinking this alpha keto acid as well as other amino acids without a permission of a doctor. Citrulline should be used with caution in people with high blood pressure. In any case, be sure to check with your doctor before using citrulline malate. Succinic acid is a unique intracellular substance that performs a universal energy-synthesizing function in the cells of the body. It participates in the synthesis of ATP and tissue respiration. By normalizing energy metabolism, it enhances the process of detoxification and elimination of various toxic substances, including drugs. Succinic acid is known with its wide range of applications in pharmaceutical, medical, and chemical. It is used as an additive in vitamin formulation and antibiotic in the pharmaceutical industry. Referring to its benefits, succinic acid seems to be a good inhibitor candidate against the coronavirus epidemic. For this reason, molecular docking simulation of succinic acid has been performed with several coronaviruses. Docking study demonstrated the binding affinities of succinic acid to the target coronavirus. One of the succinic acid derivatives is the 2-amino-5-chloropyridinium hydrogen succinate, ACPS, that has the potential inhibitor activity against SARS-CoV-2. There are insufficient studies on the antiviral activity of succinic acid in the scientific literature. However, succinic acid may have a positive effect during recovery from coronavirus infection due to its anti-hypoxic, antioxidant, and cytoprotective activity. All these effects are considered by Russian scientists in their article on the possibility of using succinate in hypoxia developing in COVID-19. The tissue hypoxia, triggering the pathomorphological cascade of events and resulting in multiple organ failure, is a central element of COVID-19 pathogenesis. Experimental and clinical studies show the positive impact of tissue hypoxia correction using succinate in both adult patients and children with various conditions associated with acute respiratory failure. There is evidence of a direct link between immunity, oxidative stress, and antioxidant status of patients with COVID-19. Oxidative stress, in turn, is the main cause of local or systemic tissue damage, which leads to a severe course of coronavirus infection. When using succinic acid, a special biochemical process, succinate oxidase oxidation, is the corrector of tissue hypoxia. It is achieved by increasing succinate dehydrogenase activity and improving the penetration of exogenous succinate into cell mitochondria. Even in the absence of oxygen, succinic acid provides a number of enzymatic reactions in the tricarboxylic acid cycle and in the respiratory chain. All of the above processes increase cell resistance to hypoxia. In addition, succinic acid supplements improve the oxygen transport function of the blood and increase the oxygen consumption of the tissues. I will leave a link to this article in the description below, where you can find the English version of this article and all other links as well. Succinic acid, when taken orally, is absorbed from the gastrointestinal tract, enters the blood and tissues, participating in the reactions of energy metabolism, and after 30 minutes it completely decomposes to the final metabolic products, carbon dioxide and water. It is contraindicated in the presence of hypersensitivity, allergic reactions, as well as in children under the age of 18, since there were no clinical studies on the corresponding group of people. The drug should be prescribed with caution to patients with diseases of the digestive system in the acute phase, such as erosion, gastric and duodenal ulcers, gastritis, duodenitis, with arterial hypertension, with nephrolithiasis, gout and hyperuricemia. It is not recommended to use succinic acid during pregnancy and lactation due to the lack of clinical data on the efficacy and safety of the drug in this category of patients. L-carnitine. L-carnitine is a natural substance related to B vitamins. It participates in complex metabolic processes, resulting in the formation of energy storage molecules adenosine triphosphate ATP and acetyl coenzyme A. This unique substance improves protein and fat metabolism, promotes food digestion, reduces excessive body weight, and decreases muscle fat content. L-carnitine also increases resistance to exercise and improves energy supply to tissues. L-carnitine is indicated in the complex therapy during rehabilitation after diseases and surgical interventions, injuries, including for the acceleration of tissue regeneration. Different studies show that L-carnitine has immunomodulatory effects that might influence the management of infectious diseases, including COVID-19. L-carnitine could help patients with COVID-19 infection in several aspects. In particular, L-carnitine might increase antioxidant status, reduce recovery time by as many as 3.5 days in patients with mild to moderate COVID-19, and also it might influence susceptibility to viral infection. L-carnitine tartrate lead to a significant and dose-dependent inhibition of the infection by SARS-CoV-2. Moreover, acetyl L-carnitine has positive effects on the development and maturation of T lymphocytes involved in the immune response to viral agents. Links to all the studies below this video. Also, if you want to learn more about L-carnitine, be sure to watch my video 6 Rare Vitamins. L-carnitine is usually prescribed in doses of 500, 750 and even 1000 mg per day. If the patient has mitochondrial disease associated with carnitine deficiency, the medication may be prescribed intravenously and in high dose of up to 50, 100 mg per kilo of weight per day. But remember, such high doses can only be prescribed by your doctor. Oxygen starvation is a constant companion of coronavirus infection. Moreover, the severity of hypoxia is often correlated with the severity of the disease. Changes in the dynamics of biochemical processes in mitochondria and a decrease in the level of coenzyme Q10 in patients with coronavirus infection may indicate a negative effect of the virus on the endogenous synthesis of coenzyme Q10 or CoQ10. The mechanism might be virus-induced oxidative stress caused by a mutation of one or more of the 9 CoQ genes, resulting in primary CoQ10 deficiency. New perspective for patients with COVID-19 may be supportive targeted therapy with coenzyme Q10 to increase the energy production, immunity, and decrease oxidative stress. Coenzyme Q10, CoQ10, has a number of important roles in the cell that are required for optimal functioning of the immune system. These include its important role as a carrier of electrons in the mitochondrial respiratory chain, which allows the coenzyme to participate in the production of ATP. Coenzyme plays an important role as a potential fat-soluble antioxidant and protects the cell from free radical-induced oxidation. In addition, CoQ10 has been reported to have an anti-inflammatory role due to its ability to suppress the expression of inflammatory genes. Recently, it was reported that CoQ10 is important for the normal functioning of the lysosome, the organelle responsible for the immune response. Several clinical studies have linked depleted CoQ10 levels with increased susceptibility to infections. Specifically, in a clinical study by Israel et al., CoQ10 supplementation was associated with a significant reduction in the risk of hospitalization due to SARS-CoV-2. A study published in the journal Experimental Gerontology shows that mitochondrial dysfunction is a key factor in determining the severity of SARS-CoV-2 infection. In particular, the authors noted the increased susceptibility to SARS-CoV-2 infection in individuals over 65 years of age, the same age by which levels of endogenous CoQ10 has become substantially depleted. Similarly, Gvozdikova et al. Believe that one of the main consequences of SARS-CoV-2 infection is virus-induced oxidative stress, imbalanced between free radical generation and antioxidant defense. Oxidative stress causes mutation in one or more of the genes responsible for CoQ10 biosynthesis, which in turn leads to mitochondrial dysfunction. In another study, the authors identified CoQ10 as a compound capable of inhibiting the SARS-CoV-2 virus through binding to the active site of a major viral protease, SARS-CoV-2 M-pro protease, required for viral replication. More information on coenzyme Q10 you can find in my video 6 Rare Vitamins, link as always in the description below. Thus, there is some scientific evidence that coenzyme Q10 may not only have antiviral activity, but it can also reduce viral susceptibility and combat the effects of infection such as oxidative stress and tissue hypoxia. So today I've analyzed 4 effective and considerably safe energy-boosting medications: citrulline, succinic acid, L-carnitine and coenzyme Q10. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, share your information and ask questions. Let's explore the huge and interesting medical world together. Take care of your body and mind. See you in the next video. Bye!